Writing. We're writing all the time in college classes, and even more so, perhaps, in blended and fully online classes. But students don't frown about it like they do in face-to-face classes with red marks. Sometimes they don't even know they're writing. There's a little bit more happiness about writing when it's internet-based writing, right? Because there's no red marks. There's also more collaboration, more interaction, more reflection, more chances to revise what they've done. The internet is a place for you to do writing as an individual, personal writing, collaborative team writing, writing that might have expert feedback from around the world, summary writing of the course contents, portfolio work, case-based learning analysis, so cases and simulations and other things online. We might be writing when we chat. We might be writing when we Twitter. We might be writing when we do blog posts. We might be writing when we have discussions on the web. We're writing all the time. And hopefully you can find ways to embed writing in a purposeful, thoughtful, reflective way to share content, share meaning, share perspectives. But do reflect on your course goals and the purpose of your class. Are you trying to build collaborative skills? Are you trying to build creativity? Brainstorming? Do you want more reflection? More professionalization, reflecting on the careers that they've chosen, maybe field placements? Or are you just trying to improve their writing skills overall? Note-taking, outlining, comparison and contrast, you know, and coherent text. So maybe you might want more discussion forums. Maybe you might want more Google Documents and spreadsheets for collaborative activities. Perhaps you choose role plays and debates to get students out of their normal traditional perspectives. Some students might be more negative in nature. You might give them a positive role in the online debates, right? You might have someone being the devil's advocate. They spring to life all sorts of writing and reflection among in and among people and interactivity. Maybe you have internships and field experiences, but think about what it is that you have online, what kind of group activities. Do you want to have more self-check activities where it's self-paced and they go through on their own? Or is it more team-based and collaborative? Is it more reaction and position papers? Or is it more moral and ethical and positions on the discipline? Are you taking stances, if you will? Are you comparing your stance to the authors or to other people or previous classes or comparing concepts and so forth? Have your students do a lot of this reflective writing and engage with other people on their reflective writings. As you do that, you'll need to develop assessment schemes. How will you assess their writing? Will it be a one score, a holistic score of some kind, or dimensionally scored for perspective, for coherence, for persuasiveness, for completeness, for originality, for resources used, for support provided for other people? How might you assess the quality of their work? Might it be peer scored, peer feedback, self-feedback, expert feedback? Well, there are many writing activities you can choose for the internet. Role play was one example I gave earlier. But you might also try critical friend activities for blogs so that you don't die when you teach online. You have a critical friend in class giving feedback. You have a student start discussion as the starter in a discussion forum. A student who wraps it up. So you have these opportunities for your students to, in fact, get involved, to do more within the class, to write more, reflect more, and so forth. Maybe they're sharing their writing with previous students for feedback who have come back as experts who have finished the class and are lending that insight and feedback to the class. Maybe the same person who starts discussion also wraps and summarizes that discussion in some way, shape, or form. There are many ways to embed writing, even within video. You might do a YouTube video with a reflective writing activity. You might write a wiki book or chapters of a wiki book. You might give them explicit feedback while they're doing their writing. If it's a field-based writing, you might give them a prompt to reflect on that writing. And you might be the one as the instructor who summarizes all the field experience writing so that if one person has a bad field experience, you can pull out all the good ones so students don't leave the discipline. You can also have all these writings be linked to the concepts of the book and talk about what concepts the students missed when they're in the field experience, what they got. Start with the positive, then end with maybe some things they missed. You might have them look at trends in the field for reflection papers, topics in the field that are emerging, or job applications of where they're currently working or where they hope to work, and have them write papers and reflections on it and provide examples from previous semesters. You also might have them reflect on lecture content, like this one coming to you. You might have your students write a reflection paper on this particular content to have them think about the key concepts of this particular session, for instance. You might have them watch a video of a famous author being interviewed about a book, or a conference keynote given by that author, or some kind of video chat. After having read the book, listened to the video, watched his presentation or interview, have them write a reflection paper. Now, there's some advice about writing. Avoid the notion of writing too much, the frustration that comes from having too much to grade, as well as students too much to write, and maybe too much to do at the end of the semester, to apportion it out over the whole semester. Use experts to give feedback, peers to give feedback, so you're not the only one. Archive previous writing samples so students can see best practices. And as you archive them, your course requirements go up, the standards go up, because you put up the best stuff, and you might put up non-examples or some of the stuff that's maybe not so good. Give explicit prompts so they know what to expect. Be very detailed of what their writing process should be like, what they should include within their papers, what the purpose and scope is of the online discussion. Without a purpose and scope, without spelling out the process, both the assessment process as well as the feedback process, students might, you know, procrastinate. They might not be able to complete the work because they haven't been given the guidance. Maybe look for supplemental thesaurus and dictionary resources and encyclopedias that you can make available as referenceware for your students. You might find the Purdue Online Writing Laboratory, or OWL, O-W-L, or the Doyle Online Writing Lab from Reed College to have useful materials for your students. Or maybe the National Council of Teachers of English. Go to that website and maybe find examples and pointers for how to do persuasive essays or summative texts or things in different genres, right? Ask permission if students post something really cool and high quality, ask permission to repost it. And if it's really high quality or close to, nudge them along to maybe get them to publish it. Help them to publish their work. It's something that's satisfying to you as well as them. Maybe have competitions, collaborations, an external audience evaluating that writing content so they can get excited about the audience that exists beyond the instructor or beyond your class. When you add international audiences, all of a sudden, students write more, think more thoughtfully, more carefully. And don't have everything due at the end, or you'll die. They'll die, right? Get things in early. Get feedback early. If you do a writing example early, you can avoid some plagiarism later on because you know they're writing from early on. So embed that feedback early in the course so they know someone cares about them. They know there's others reading their work. And then once you've done all this stuff, evaluate what works. Get their feedback on the writing tasks that worked or didn't work. Look at the traditional classrooms that you've been teaching and compare that. Create a set of scaffolds and writing aids that you can put on the web to scaffold their writing, to provide that support, to give them some kind of external help or writing aid so that they can be successful writers. And even borrowing examples from other people might be helpful. And for international students, you might find a writing center to get them some support. Whatever it is, think about writing all the time within the class. There's many opportunities for writing, many things that you can be doing within student writing to get them to think about themselves as writers, to get them to think about the content in the field more coherently, and to get them to synthesize and distill things down. Get them on the road to writing journeys, because the internet is a gigantic writing tool, not a gigantic toilet. I hope you got something out of this writing session. Good luck to you in your future. How can you foster reflective writing and effective and interactive writing online? Good luck.